Welcome to the Rockbridge Regional Library Storytime Live. I am Miss Wendy and I am joined with Miss Carol, who is behind the camera at the moment. And I'm so glad you could be here with us. It is Wednesday, August 26th. It is very sunny and bright out there. I see blue skies. I also think it's kind of hot. We got a warm day upon us, which is good. So I think it's a wonderful day for some stories. So should we get started? I think so. Okay, so of course, our very first song is our Hello Friends song. And the way that goes is we'll say hello, and then these are our friends. Now, Rose tried to convince me last night that friends should actually be, I forget what she said, like fingers, because here's the body and here's their heads, and if they're gonna like be friends, they need to. I said, no, let's just do this. So, and then it's time to say hello. Okay, so let's get started. And maybe I can convince Miss Carol to play a little ukulele as I sing, because that helps everything. Alrighty, here we go.
Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. It's time to say hello.
Let's do it again.
Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. It's time to say hello.
Thank you for improvising that, Miss Carol. That's awesome. So this week, I thought it would be fun. We're all getting excited about school. We're all getting excited about seeing our teachers again and learning new things. So I thought it was a good opportunity for us to refresh some of our skills, some of the things we've been learning already. So this week, we're going to talk about colors and shapes and numbers and letters. I knew there was one more. So this week's going to be all about kind of remembering all of those things. So first things first, it's time to wake up our feet. So Miss Carol, I'm going to put my mask on. Would you mind joining me to wiggle our feet together? Now I'm wondering if I should just do this a little bit.
Oh, I think so, because you know, I had you sitting, but let's just adjust that.
How's that?
Back just a little more.
Great. So if you remember this one, guys, it's called Wake Up Feet. And first, we're going to wake up our feet, okay? Obviously. So here we go. One, two, three. Wake up feet. Wake up feet. Wake up feet and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up feet. Wake up feet. Wake up and wiggle in the morning. So there it is. This time, let's wake up our hands.
Okay.
Wake up hands. Wake up hands. Wake up hands and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wake up hands. Wake up hands. Wake up and wiggle in the morning. What do you think we should wiggle next? We've got one more. Fingers? Wake up fingers, wake up fingers, wake up and wiggle, 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 wiggle. I'll mess it up. Wake up fingers, wake up fingers, wake up and wiggle in the morning. Perfect. All right, I feel ready. I feel like I'm sufficiently warmed up. So that leaves just one question, you guys. Are you ready for a story? Miss Carol, are you ready for a story?
I am.
I am too. I've been looking forward to it. So let's get on with it. One, two, three.
If you're ready for a story, clap your hands. If you're ready for a story, clap your hands. If you're ready for a story, if you're ready for a story, if you're ready for a story, clap your hands. If you're ready for a story, stomp your feet. If you're ready for a story, stomp your feet. If you're ready for a story, if you're ready for a story, if you're If you're ready for a story, sit real still. If you're ready for a story, if you're ready for a story, if you're ready for a story, sit real still.
Let's see how long we can hold it. Okay, take a deep breath. Hold it, hold it, hold it. That always makes me feel better too. Just taking that one quick deep breath. So, I thought the first thing we should read is about numbers, but I have a joke, first and foremost. And we'll see if Miss Carol knows it. Miss Carol, why was 6 afraid of 7?
I don't know.
Because 7, 8, 9! Okay, that's my really great felt 7 and 9. If you look closely, you will see that 7 is very vicious. 9 already has a bite taken out, and there they go. It is scary.
Oh, poor 9.
I know, but he's running. He's in front, so I think it's okay, he or she. So, you know, Miss Carol, have you heard that joke?
I have.
I know, everybody knows that joke. Now, this book is kind of about that joke, and it's super funny. This is called 7, 8, 9, The Untold Story. This is written by Tara Lazar and illustrated by Ross McDonald. Oh boy, a lot going on here. It's brought to us by Disney Hyperion Publishing. All right, here we go. I was dozing off in my chair when an urgent banging on my office door bolted me awake. It was 6. Something had scared the pants off him. 7 is coming to get me, said 6. Yeah, see. As a private eye, see, he's the letter I, I'm used to this type of thing, numbers. They're always stuck in a problem. But I knew about this 7 fella. He was odd. 7's an odd number. Take it easy, 6, I said. What's up? What's 7 up to? Word on the street is that 7, 8, 9. And now he's after me, said 6. Well, technically, he's always after you, I said. 5, then 6, then 7. See? That proves it. I told 6 not to panic. Stay here. I'll get to the root of this. I hope so, said 6. I fear my days are numbered. First, I went looking for 8. She's usually caught between 7 and 9. I found her at the corner of 2nd Avenue and 4th Street, but 8 knew nothing. Nada. Zilch. Which means nothing. If it's true, 8 said, then I'm next in line. In a flash, she took off her belt. Now 8 looked just like 0. Oh, good disguise. So it was 0 all along. I needed a solid lead. I strolled into Cafe Uno, leaned on the counter, and ordered a slice of pie. B, the waitress, had the scoop. Yeah, I heard of 7, 8, 9, she said. So you haven't seen 9 around? I asked. Negative, said B. He just disappeared. So 9 was gone. I couldn't let 7 be the one who got away. But I needed more data. I went to see 11. She and 7 are like 2 peas in a pod. 7 couldn't have done it, said 11. He's on vacation. Are you sure? I prodded. I'm positive. I saw him leave. There he goes. But if 7 was gone, then where was 9? It didn't add up. Frustrated, I headed back uptown. That's when I saw him crossing the street. Finally, I put 2 and 2 together. Oh. I had to get back to the office. On the double, I told the driver. There he goes. I busted through my office door and found 6 taking 40 winks. I have solved this numerical nonsense, I cried. I grabbed 6 and I turned him around. turned him upside down. His true color was revealed. Just as I suspected, my client 6 was really 9. You had everybody worried, 9, I said. Why did you say that 7, 8, 9? Because 7 gets all the attention. Lucky 7. 7 wonders of the world. Snow White and the 7 dwarfs. Figures. 9 felt like he didn't measure up. 7, 7, 7. It's like I don't exist. Folks hurry right past me on their way to 10. Don't even get me started on 10. Everyone thinks he's perfect. The perfect 10. I zeroed in on 9. Are you kidding? You should be on cloud 9 right now. Happy as can be, the whole 9 yards. How come? Asked 9. Because you've got 9 lives. That's a good point. That's when 11 showed up. Look who's back, she said. It was 7. Stammered 9. No hard feelings, 7, old pal. Sure. Let's not be divided, 7 said, which is good. They made up. He didn't mind. 7 seemed awfully pleased for a number who had been framed. Why so happy, 7? I asked. I just sailed the 7 seas, and I'm in 7th heaven. Good point. So he was on vacation. At last, everyone was back in order, and now I could take letter cases again. Letters can be wordy at times, but they're A-OK in my book. The next day, while dozing in my chair, my phone bolted me awake. I'd recognize her voice anywhere. It was 2, with another problem to solve. I've really got to change my number. Oh, there they are. Missing number 9. There's the prime suspect. There's a client, but it's actually that guy. Wow. Yeah, so do we know that numbers could be so complicated? I didn't. They've got a lot going on. So this leads me to another song, okay? Now, this is a counting song, and I think you guys might know it. It's called 5 Green Speckled Frogs. That was a lot. 5 Green Speckled Frogs. Okay, so I'm going to give this a shot. And here's what we do. You're going to put your arm out. This is your log, your speckled log. And then you have 5 frogs. You also just have 5 fingers, and that's okay too. Okay, so we'll put our frogs on our log. And this is how it goes. 5 green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. 1 jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are 4 green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. All right, that leaves 4. 4 green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. 1 jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are 1, 2, 3 green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Pardon my mask. Now let's do 3. 3 green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. 1 jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are 2 green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. 2 green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. 1 jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are 1 green speckled frog. Glub, glub. Last one. 1 green and speckled frog sat on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. 1 jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are no green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. All right, that is my green speckled frog. They went flying. I'll just put them back there so that they don't end up like on my back, and I don't realize it because I've leaned back on them.
It looks like they're in a pool.
Yep, they're hanging out with an octopus.
Yeah, nice.
Oh, and this reminds me, guys, don't forget about your story time bags. Now,
I'm actually not using anything from it today, I just realized, but this is here for you. If you would like one of these bags so that you have shakers and scarves to use during story time, just send me a message on Facebook and I will make sure there's one for you holding. All right, so it's time for another book. Now this one, I figured we've talked about numbers. It's time we should probably talk about letters too. So I'm assuming you guys all know your letters. So let's refresh a little bit. Here's a new book. Now this one I really like because there's lots and lots of letters and lots of things that start with those letters. So this is kind of a test a little bit. Can we find all the things on each page? So this is called An Excessive Alphabet. Avalanches of A's to Zillions of Z's. And this is written by Judy Barrett and illustrated by Ron Barrett. Oh boy, lots of words. This is brought to us by Athenium Books for Young Readers. Avalanches of A's. All right, where are A's? Addition, ant, apple, arrow. What else do we have? Artichoke, angel. What's that guy? I don't know what that is.
Alien.
Alien! I figured it was an insect.
It does look like it.
Acorn, arm, oh my, airplane? Boatloads of bees. Okay, we got a baby in a bathtub. We've got bread and butter. We've got a bunny. We've got balloon, bed, beard, broccoli. Wow. Cans of C's. Where are the C words? This is nothing but C words, I think. Cans, corn, clock, cow, cookie, camel, carrots. What else did you see in there? Is that a crab using crayons? It is a crab using crayons. Dozens of D's. Dolphin. Daisy. Dinosaur. Duck. Drum. Doll. Dollar. You see any others? Now this is a cool one. Endless E's. Can you see all the E's? Look at that. Psh, 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 psh. They're all over. All of this pattern is made up of E's. And it's also an easel. Then you've got elephant. Eggplant. Earth. Do you see any other ones? Look at his shirt. Eggs. Interesting. F. Flocks of F. Feet. Fish, four, fire, feather. Do you see others? Who's that? Frog. Globs of G's. What? Guitar. Grapes. Ghost. Who's that? Uh-oh. Giraffe's getting his hooves stuck.
Oh, in glue, perhaps.
In glue. I didn't even think of the glue. And look, there's the gingerbread man. He's stuck. Herds of H. Hula. Hydrant. Hat. Horse. Hammer. Oh my gosh, there's just so many. House. Helicopter. Hippo. Islands of eyes. Iguana. Ice cream. Iron. What's happening here, though? Baby? I don't understand that one. Let me know if you think. No. Eyes? No, that's not eyes. That's E. I don't know. Ice skate. Maybe there's a key at the end. Jumbles of J's. Jets. Juice. Jackets. Jelly beans. King size K's. Koala. Kiss. Kangaroo, key, kite, loads of L's, leopards, lifeguard, ladybug, leg, and lipstick. Okay, mountains of M's, mummy, mustard, mayonnaise, mushrooms, monkey,
and milk. Networks of ends. Necktie. Necklace. Nose. Note. Nails. Do you see any others? Look at that. Needle. Oodles of O's. My favorite animal. Octopus. Owl. Overalls. Somebody else's favorite animal. Ostrich. Someone somewhere. Piles of peas. You've got pizza. You've got pickles. Plants. Pumpkins. Quarts of cues. Quilt. Queen. And then what does he say? Quack. Quarterback? Quill? Question. Racks of R's. You see some R words there? Rainbow. Ruler. Rain. Radish. Robin. And swarms of S's. Shark. Snake. Spaceship. Sub. Seal. Spoon. SWAT, I guess. Truckloads of T's. Look at those T words. Toast, toilet, tub, and turkey. But don't forget, Tyrannosaurus Rex. Train. And umpteen U's. Oh, goodness. Well, there's one. Unicorn. Underpants. And UFO. So there is the alien. There he is. All right. Volumes of V's, vegetables, violins. What else do I have? Vacuum, vulture, vine, volcano. The floor is lava. Whopping amounts of W's. Wreath, wheelchair, weight, walrus. Do you see any others? Witch. I think I saw waffles. Extra X's. X-rays. What else is... what is this?
I see a xylophone.
Xylophone. Okay. Wow. That's all we got. That's a tough one. Why? Yards of Y's. Yo-yo. Yarn. Yacht. Excellent. And, of course, zillions of Z's. Zucchini. Zipper. Z. I'm like, go zebra. Goldfish. I don't know.
Zombie.
Zombie. Yeah, I don't know. This is interesting. We're going to have to go back and look at this closer. This is not the end. Turn the page this way to a ton of things. Oh, gosh. See how many of these things you can find in the pages in this book. Oh, gosh. So this is, if you check out this book, you can go back and see if you can find all of these things is found in the pages. So next time you're thinking about the alphabet, just remember there are so many words. You know all the words that start with the letters. There's that zombie. I mean, that alien again. I'm kind of obsessed with him now. all right. I've got another song, guys. One more song. And this one is about shapes. So this one, let's see. This, I'm gonna make a shape with my hands. And I wanna see if you can do the shape too. So here's how you do it. Miss Carol, I can show you if you wanna join me.
Okay.
So it goes to the song of Mary Had a Little Lamb.
Oh.
So first we're gonna come up with a shape with our hands. How about this shape? So do you see this shape, friends? Okay, so this is how the song goes. Do you know what shape this is? Shape this is, shape this is. Do you know what shape this is? And do you have one too? And then you at home can put your shape together. And it goes, if you have it, wave it high, wave it high, wave it high. If you have it, wave it high and say hooray for circles. So that was our shape. So this time, let's try this shape. You put your thumbs together
and then you curl your hands. Can you guys make that shape?
Oh.
Do you know what shape this is? Shape this is. Shape this is. Do you know what shape this is? And do you have one too? If you have it, wave it high. Wave it high. Wave it high. If you have it, wave it high and say hooray for hearts. Okay, let's try one more. How about put your thumbs together?
This is hard.
How about that one?
Okay.
You guys, can you tell what shape that is?
Do you know what shape this is? Shape this is. Shape this is. Do you know what shape this is? And do you have one too? If you have it, wave it high. Wave it high. Wave it high. If you have it, wave it high and say hooray for
triangles! Excellent. So we did circle, heart, and triangles. So we'll try to do other shapes tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay, I do have one more book. I feel like I'm running late, but we might as well
do it.
This one is about color. So of course, when we get to school, we learn all about different colors.
Can I show them all these wonderful shapes and numbers and letters and colors?
Yeah.
That is so awesome.
Let's see if we can do them. A. I think we should sing it.
Oh, let's do.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? Now look at these shapes too.
And they're colored too.
So we have, what do we have here?
It looks to me like an orange circle.
Orange circle. How about that one?
Is it a purple oval?
It is. What do we have here?
I think it's a red rectangle.
Now this is Rose's favorite color.
That's Rose's pink square.
Perfect. And then this one?
That is a yellow triangle.
Now this one.
Oh boy.
Here's a hard one.
Oh boy.
But I'd love saying this word. It's a parallelogram. Can you say parallelogram?
A blue parallelogram.
Parallelogram. I think we need to come up with a song about parallelograms.
Oh, yes, that's a good word.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that.
Maybe not on the fly.
Not on the fly for sure. But these are all things that we'll be starting to learn again when we get back to school. And you can, you can start learning them now. So this book is called Frankencrayon, but don't be afraid. It'll be okay. It's by Michael Hall. Frankencrayon, this picture book has been canceled. I don't know. I didn't realize that. Official notice. This picture book has been canceled. Please close the book and find something else to read.
Oh, gosh.
I'm not prepared
just
for that.
Wait, can I just you peek and just
yeah,
see?
Let's see what it says. Oh, it looks like they're confused, too. I can't believe it's been canceled. It was my first starring role. It was my first supporting role. Yeah, this is brought to us by Green Willow Books. Help! Someone just turned the page! Take my hand. Hey, someone must be reading this book. You're right. I'll talk to them. Pencil's going to talk to us. Hello out there. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but this picture book has been canceled. Tell them what happened. Tell them about the scribble. And don't leave anything out. Okay, I guess we're going to find out. They're going to tell us. This is good. Well, let's see. In the beginning, everything went according to plan. The crayons were in their costumes, and I was getting them into position. I got teal and lime. This should be fun. I'm so excited. Amber, royal blue. I hope I don't forget my lines. Frankencrayon, go to page 22. That's where you'll make your dramatic entrance, just like we practiced. All right, so there's crayons all put together. You've got purple, orange, green.
Right, got it. Page 22. So he's going to go. Okay. Let's see what happens. The story began with the frightened townspeople talking about a horrible monster lurking in their town. There is a horrible monster lurking in our town. Oh, no. I'm so scared. Suddenly, without warning, the lights went out.
No.
Squeak! Uh-oh. What is it? Amber, what is it? Someone turn on the lights, please. It was a scribble. It went all the way across two pages. It's horrifying. Hideous. Horrendous. A scribble can ruin a picture book. Don't worry. We'll take a short break while the crew cleans the page. But the scribble got bigger. I think we made it worse. It's absolutely awful. Appalling. Atrocious. It's making a mess of our story. Cast members, we need more help. Even four crayons scribbling hard couldn't stop the scribble. That didn't go well either. It's distressing. Disturbing. Dreadful. We need more help. Hurry, please. But the scribble was out of control. It's alive. We've created a monster. Let's get out of here. They're just going to run. The story was falling apart. And that's when the really terrible news arrived. Official notice. We regret to tell you that we've decided to cancel this picture book. How come? We're almost halfway done. Official notice. Because, number one, no one likes the scribbling thing. And number two, the characters are gone. Number three, isn't there supposed to be a mad scientist in this story? Yes, but I dropped the mad scientist because he was difficult. Official notice! We know you're disappointed, but we ask that you leave this book right away. Uh-oh. I don't know. I don't want to leave this book. No, I need to know what happened. Okay.
Oh my.
What could I do? I turned out the lights and left. Oh, he pencil just said, I'm out of here. And that's what happened. Whoa, whoa, hang on, hang on. That's not the whole story. You know what we're talking about. Oh, you forgot to tell us. Okay, let's see. Well, I was pretty upset at the time. And in my sadness, I forgot to tell Frank and Crayon. So on page 22, Wait, where are the frightened townspeople? Isn't this page 22? I'll turn the lights on. Oh, hello. Who are you? I don't think it can talk. Let's give it a mouth and hop off. Oh, okay. Well, they gave him a mouth. Hello. I need to get moving. I'm late for an important event. Can you help me? Of course we can. That's what crayons do. I'll fix you up in a flash. So they gave him a voice. Thank you. Oh, they added legs. Now he can go. What a beautiful scribble. I wish it didn't have to go. Come on, let's find the frightened townspeople. Eventually, I came back to look for the costumes and found Frank and Crayon eating oranges in the green room. Where's everybody? We have a few things to tell you two. I have horrible news. I guess that's about it. We'll probably never know who scribbled on the page to begin with, but at least this has been a learning experience for all of us. Right. Lesson number one. Don't forget to tell everyone when a story has been canceled. Lesson number two. Don't try to unscribble a scribble by scribbling on it. That's important. Lesson number three. Even a messy scribble can be a lovely thing. Goodbye. Isn't that a treat? Wait, don't forget lesson number four. Never drop the mad scientist from the Frankenstein story. Official notice. It was him. He canceled it. Yes. Oh, scandalous. So, again, colors are really complicated, too. I guess it's not just numbers that can be complicated. That's a fun book. So, you guys, we have completed our
first story time, our first back to school story time. So I will see you tomorrow. Just a few notes. If you're interested in Makers Club, there is still space. Just send me a message at wredfern, R-E-D-F-E-R-N, at rrlib.net, and I will sign your child up. We also still have room in our Lego club, which is super awesome. So without further ado, I'm trying to think if there was something else, but without further ado, it's time to wash our hands. Now that we've done all this, we need to wash our hands so we can have our snack. That's me talking to myself. All right, so here we go. Hand washing song. Tops and bottoms, tops and bottoms, in between, rub them all together, rub them all together, now they're clean, squeaky clean. Again, tops and bottoms, tops and bottoms, in between, rub them all together, rub them all together, now they're clean, squeaky clean. Very good. I find that doing it twice is about 20 seconds, so that's the amount of time we need to wash our hands. Okay, last one. See you later, alligator. Are you ready? All right. See you later, alligator. In a while, crocodile. Give a hug, ladybug. Blow a kiss, jellyfish. All right. See you soon, big baboon. Out the door, dinosaur. Take care, polar bear in underwear. Oh my gosh, it just went blank. Oh my gosh, I lost this.
I'm sorry, I forgot.
Wave goodbye, butterfly.
I apologize, you guys, but thank you for clapping. That makes me feel much better, Miss Carol. I appreciate it. We shall see you tomorrow at 10:30 for more Storytime Fun. Till then, see you later.